Hello, in this video I try to make the new storage chests and bunkers, and with the new designs included in the next version. And now I switch these graphics and need some ideas for making this and this new. And for this I have made a screenshot from Borderlands, and I like this design and these. So I think I made something looks nearly the same or a little bit different and more details, but this design for a great storage chest I think looks good. So here I have a design I made before, and I need make this in a neutral color like this chest. So I bring only the colors down and make an icon and let's see. This is the connector for the robots, so I don't need them in my new chest, but I need to place something new here to look not so boring. First I think I change the colors. Okay. This color. And I can take the correct color from this, and from this I also want the plate and the grip. This color. So it's easy to reuse some things if you have had make an good design what you like. It's 2x2 and originally I think I give this chest 30 only, but later I changed this to 80. So the factory design shows now the correct inventory. And from here the plate and the grip. And because this is sides one by one and the grip is this side, I need to make this grip also smaller. And maybe two grips. Let's see. And to make it more perfect, I think I split up this plate. It's not good. Now I make another line. This way it's, I think, easier, but you can also extrude and inner extrude or with a knife make a new line, but in this I use this method. Okay, now I tweak the hinge at this end. It's this. And I make it here a little bit easier for me. Make also easy tweaks to look this hinge nice. Only extrude and inner extrude. Like so. Maybe 14. Yeah, looks good. And a new transform with maybe 20 or 10. And now I break this direction and the center I make a little bit like this, and I think that's good enough. needs the color from the top cover to look a little bit better. Right. So I can select this. And freeze my selection and top. This and this. What color? Oh, this. This clipping here can deactivate it by switching no camera selected, and you see here a clipping, and this can deselect by camera and near clipping off. Now I can make the charnier hinge look a little bit nicer, but maybe it's too much detail, so I skip this. I think I skip this. Looks a little better in my opinion, so I go with this. And I think that's it for the new 2x2 chest. I check here the shadow and looks good. So I think it's good enough to export. Storage and C21. Yes. Okay, and I need an icon. Two. And for this I need to make the turn off the shadow, and I use composition and this option. It needs an output side from 32x32, and now I can move this into position and yeah, can work. And 20 I can. So okay. Now I want this and this. From this chest I have made no logistic chest, but from this side, and maybe the big, I need to think about it. But this chest also a new smart chest in new version, so it's possible to connect cables. So now let's see if the design is good enough or not. All starts with a cube ever. So and the corners, I think I like this round shape here and the bottom, and I try to achieve the same effect or look a little bit. And maybe the best option is to use this torus, and let's see. Also, I have here my camera view and need to change this to 4 because my chest is now 3x3 and I need a 4th field tile for the shadows. And also I need made a good sides to check what's going on and how it looks. And also I need a ground floor for better preview. Like this. Okay, now to this. Because the graphics in Factorio is so small, I need to make it a little bit bigger so it's good to see in game. Nope. I can also use a part of this, but it's okay. So I use symmetry to make it a little bit easier to adjust the rings. And also I need later symmetry or area to move this around at the corners. It's the fastest and way to get this into position. Also possible is of course symmetry object and make more symmetries like so, and again 4. Like so. So. A separate cube for the button and name it I think it can be easier to do it this way. So it's okay. Before I bevel this, I need to make the corners look a little bit rounder. Now I need to remove the phone. So I have this details. Now it's the corner. And to make a better looking, maybe not, transition, I can choose the tools and edit a little bit, but at the moment I think this is okay. And I knew. And I take the bottom and use it for the top again. It's in the ground because it's new objects generally generated at point zero, so it needs to be lifted. And now I move a point from this whole object or group and can now it place it on ground. This is an instance and this allow me to transfer all changes from this to this and makes it a lot more easier to make things like this. And now I change the radius, not this radius, the pipe radius, and now I can line this up new and have more detailed looking at this port. And it's a little bit rough, and I think I go for this, and so. Let's see, top. And for the top, I use inner extrude. Yes, like so, like the downport. And now I make a new transform, but only maybe 14, and again, and this with 8, and break the whole top port with this extrude line. Now I need to bring up the center cube so it's more. Looking like this, but the edges look tough, so I remove the sides. Okay, you see the shadow, but this comes from because I look from the wrong side. I need to look from this side, and it's more. This is also the later the in-game view of this chest type. So, but it's a little bit too deep inside. I go with 280 and make this side round so it's look like this, and the edges don't come out, and I need to remove the foam. In the center, it comes the text plate for no reason but to make look more interesting. If I can find, it's here, I think, yes, here. And this is 3x3, and I think what sides? Yeah, 140. Okay. It's okay. And downsides to place it into position. It needs more downsizing. Now I need the knife because I want a plain cut, and these three parts are make to the parts here, to the tiles here, so it looks like splitted like this and this and more. Just a little detail. Not matching perfect. Enough, and now I can select this and extrude and now I think it looks good, but the center cube needs a little bit bigger again. And maybe I split the center cube also with these lines, so it's more streamlined looking. Now I need to tweak these edges. I make a copy from my torso and change this to what I think it's looking best at this position, and it's, I think, half selection of this torus. Now it's a little bit hard to cut in the right place. Okay. Now I need to merge all these unused points. And now I can extrude this like so, and I think I can, yeah, it's okay. It's okay, but I need to go a step backward, because this circle is smaller than this, and I won't make another cut line to break the surface, and so it's better it equals the radius or diameter. And this up. It's not to see because it's down, but I bring it up in a in a moment. So it's okay now. This overlapping, and now this needs also overlap. And now I can move the whole thing a little bit higher. It looks still a little bit strange. But I don't want to move this completely out, because I think it looks more strange when. Maybe I should only try a different design, like I finish this shortly, and let's try a different design. Okay, how it looks now. Okay, but not perfect. So I forget this. And I make a new test, a new idea, and for this I take the bottom. I make a copy. No, the bottom I have ruined with this. So I take the top. I make a copy, because sometimes things go wrong, and so I have a chance to repair it later. Okay, and now extrusion. Test this from the bottom. Maybe it's easier and look nicer. But for this, top is enough. Like so, and 42 minutes I'm recording. Let's see. Okay, let's try. Sometimes it's not easy to find a good solution or the right idea to make things look good. But this is how it works sometimes. So now I can change the lines. And ripple the corners again. And I can make this all around. Little mistake, this is the front side and I need to make this on the front side, but it's not a problem. I go for this and 5 and 5, it's too much, and also wieso. Okay, off and top needs rotated. Yeah, I think it looks a little bit better or more smooth than the other variant with the swings. Yeah, I take the sharp variant. So now this is okay, I think. This looks okay. And I think I use also these lines from the bottom to the top. maybe 50 and this, no, 46 and 46 and 55. So, and with this I can highlight these parts. A little bit, and also this part. So now I need a connection point for the cable and also a hinge and a top cover, and for the robo port chest I need to make this docking thing. And yeah, let's do this. I take the port from here and want to see how it looks, and if it's good enough I will take it over and I'm done with this port or chest. It's too big. Still too big. I don't use Freescale not very much because I want to have more control, and but it's also possible, you can see here. And maybe I need now free from this handles and covers. But let's see how it looks with two. I think it's good, but I think I change the look a little bit and move things around to look more bigger and how it should look. I will say now I think the grips Not visible, so I need change this to grips on both sides, I think, or make them a little bit like this. So it's more of an illusion. You can grip, take your hand here and swing this cover up, and also for the other side. But I can use symmetry again. It's easier for positioning and like so. And now grips go knee down. And they are a little too big, so yeah, this is more, this is a better size for this. On and additions, now I make the hinge a little bit smaller and add also two of them. And it's symmetry, so I can use this symmetry object here to make it easier. I think I tweak this genre a little bit because I want this a little bit bigger, and like so, and I rotate these also like this and stepping down. Now I need to connect all points, and for this part I also think it can be a little bit more out. Maybe it was too much. For the next chest, I need to make a better hinge graphic or model. So and I need to work with this. So this opens this side and this. Now I think I can close the polygon holes with the option, and this is a little bit better, so I can select and deselect this separate parts better, I hope. And let's make this so. This, and now I can deselect these parts again, and move it a little bit more. And now it's okay. Better. Now I need to make change the colors and I think, and when I think it's done. It should not look too bad, and let's see. This is in-game view. But not correct sides, and this the new sides, and 3x3, and let's take a look. Yeah, I think it will work in the game. This off, and now I need colors. Bottom. For this I need to select the tops. Split the top into different sections. So I think it's easier to apply nice colors. And this is a section. Also, I want this inside and different section. And the reason for this is I can create for this when nice effects, nice glowings and so and so it's look more interesting. Let's see if I apply this, and this comes here, and this section, this top section, I think I can use this dark gray. For better view. So I now I can switch different colors and make the chests more look more interesting, and this is the only reason I have separated this now. And okay, so the bottom part, the bottom. Test this. It looks okay. The center. I need to remove the bump and take this and this column. Let's see. Very, very bright. I will take this off. And I need a darker background to get a better look. Too dark now, and for this, I think I give a little bit color. But not too much, because the recipe, it's from Unicomp N4, so it makes a little bit sense, or structure element with a little blue tint, so it makes sense to have a little bit blue in this graphic. Okay, all very dark. So I like this top light. I can this use later also for the different logistic chests. And this blue is too much. And this blue I have reserviert for requester and provider chest. So I can only tweak these colors or make a new one. But this, of course, too light. Switch the ports and from here I remove the bump and give a little bit more blue. Also in the reflection a little bit blue. So, and this is my bottom and top and now I need to add this selection to this color. Not too bad. Yes, I need to test no, it's a lightning thing, so I can't do much. And for the text, it's too much. Okay. And a little bit more darker and more blue. These white lines come from the bevel modifier, and looks strange. And I have no idea how I can remove this. So I think I remove this option. Another option is I can use subdivision, but I think it will not work as I wanted. And I think I tried to give this a color, but no. It uses the base color with gray and yeah. So I think I try another option and make this like this and try here a bevel. I need to use a line modifier, a line selection, and this can help in this part, I think. Like so. And I have a different selection also here. No, same lines, okay. So I have this, and now I need to reselect all these parts. Okay. And I try this also for the mid section here, to get bit a little bit smoother. And now I think I'm done with this storage chest. Second light comes from shadow, a little bit more light, and now correct things, settings, and can move a little bit up. It's a little bit too dark. I need a little bit highlight. And also, I think I use more, a little bit more sharpening. Strange. Looks better. Blue makes it hard to see. It's not a request or chest, so I need to remove blue again and change this to a little bit green, because green is for the smart chests, so I hope it's more clear in this direction now, and it's yeah, I think it's okay. And the orange ring, it's not good for this. I think I take like this blue. Maybe a little bit more green. This is okay for me, but of course, I had it can be blue. I have no big requester or provider chests, but now it's green. C10 green. And Now I need to bring it into the game. It's no problem. I have my shifting tool here, and of course I need to find it. And here it's the chest, and this is the in-game, and I need to copy the icon from something here. No, this copy and paste, and now it's this at school. And also I can switch this graphics to old icon for now store. So, and now positioning. Maybe it looks good, looks round and nice. 128 and for the other graphic, it's okay. Start again, and I have missed the path. And now we look in game. Looks huge, bigger than this part, but I think it's maybe okay. But this chest have a different angle. And I think I need to fix this. It's dark in this pod. I make this a little bit taller, and yeah, and this can I make, of course. Now let's take And for this, the text should not scale it, but the whole thing. So I take a chance and take it 10% down, and test this again. Looks still okay. And rename this to old. And okay. Same parameters, looks good. And quit. Yes, better. Much better. The same style for the logistic storage bunker and for the big. But for the big, I think a little bit more details and some different things. But this is okay, I think. It looks now a container and storage and logistic chest becomes this robo thing at the top. Thank you for watching and goodbye.